Hey Gemini, welcome to your April 2020 General Tarot reading. This is Lauren with the Claroticure. Welcome back. So if you're new to my channel today and happen to stop by, thank you so much for clicking on this video. And if you want to receive messages that resonate for you, definitely hit that subscribe button, baby, and smash that bell icon so you're notified every time I upload a reading. For those of my returning subscribers, thank you so much for all your love and support. I'm going to attempt to do 24 videos this month. These will be the first 12, the general reading, and then I will continue to do Who's My Future Partner as well. For those of you that have been around, know that it's kind of my signature reading. I've been doing it for a long time. Leave me a heart emoji in the comment section if you still want to see these readings, have these readings. I could also include a little mini love spread as well. Meaning cup for couples in that Who's My Future Partner as well, kind of maybe expanded a little bit. I'm trying to bring as much content as I can to you guys. So with all that being said, let's jump into your reading. You are definitely moving through a healing cycle here, Gemini, for the month of April 2020. I see that you will be moving forward more than likely in some type of new career or a new opportunity to advance here in your life, okay? Now, it may not be everything you ever wanted, but it's your time. You know, you're going to get what you deserve here in Gemini. So if you put the hard work in, it's not even about that. You got a tower moment going on here. You have one, two, three, four major arcanas. So there's stuff bubbling up behind the scenes that is to get you pointed in the right direction here. Now, when I see the tower, I don't normally panic, but it is kind of a scary looking card. The good news, and this is what I'm picking up on, is that, oh yeah, look at this. Look what you've been deceived in the past here, Gemini. Something went down with the Seven of Swords under there. You're coming out of a situation that was not an honest situation. Could have been betrayal. Could have been your own deception. But maybe you took a risk and it just didn't work out. Or, you know, somebody was trying to get away with something, cheat or steal from you, and boom, whatever is going on, okay, this is going to come to fruition in the month of April. Whoa, 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 what's under that? Yeah, you've been stabbed. Get the Ten of Swords here. Oh my God, you have the Ten of Swords here too. This flipped out. This is from my a new deck that I'm working with, the Tarot of Dreams, Ciro Marchetti's depiction. Let me show you this. The Ten of Swords. Yeah, you definitely have been stabbed in the back here, Gemini. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So, looks like maybe you moved forward. Oh, had to really fight for something here. Maybe there was some, wow, pessimistic trickery or something like that. A lot of gossip and stuff going on here. You would definitely dealing with a very, very difficult situation. Part of this is taking a chance to get ahead, which some of you I see here with the Wheel of Fortune coming into play here is that the wheel is turning in your favor for the month of April. Gemini, so things are going to be really looking up for you. Whatever you dealt with in the past leading up to now, yeah, your little world is going to be shook like a globe and not in a bad way, okay? So whatever's been false in your life, whatever blocks that you've been dealing with, even spiritual or personal development growth in that kind of way is coming down. You're going to be able to see your way clear here. So get prepared for some big sudden change. Lies too. You may find out more that went on. Maybe you don't even know right now, okay? The whole story is what I'm picking up on. But The good news here is that you have temperance in your recent past. You've been trying to heal from this situation. You've been trying to find your balance. Okay. Going with the flow, getting on the right path here. You're being guided. You've been patient. You've been working very hard on not letting your emotions get to you with the temperance card. This is Sagittarius. Tower is Scorpio. Wheel of Fortune is ruled by Jupiter, so Sag or Pisces here. The Hanged Man is Pisces. You got a lot of water energy. You know, I'm filming these at the end of March. We're just coming out of March. Pisces season, Neptune's in Pisces. We had Mercury retrograde in Pisces. So, yeah, I can see kind of this energy still coming through for you, Gemini, you know. And maybe it was a tough month for you, March leading into April, because you know, you're an air sign, and having Pisces, you know, in your ruler, Gemini, can make your life feel insane, okay? So with that being said, though, I feel like the past is behind you and you're on the right path now to move forward. You're going to have an opportunity that comes to you in April, which is of good luck. Fate, timing, something that is meant to be. There's a brand new cycle with doors opening for you of change, success, growth, prosperity, new opportunities, okay? Things finally turning around, some divine timing here, which is also significant in the Temperance card as well. So Lady Luck is pointing her finger at you, and let me tell you something. Not to jump ahead, but you have the Six of Pentacles as your final outcome. So this is a pretty amazing reading. You're getting what you deserve. You maybe screwed over in the past. You were giving and giving, and now it's your time to receive. This could come to you in the way of money, loans, grants, promotions, new job, clients' money. The generosity is here. So I want you to ask for it now, you know. As you move through the month of April, know that this is coming to you. I mean, I see you being able to move through this opportunity, even though it might not be everything you want. Okay, there's some sacrifices that might have to be made here with the Hanged Man, your second Pisces card. Hold on, I can't even pick it up. This is your advice. Okay, so the Hanged Man indicates that, yeah, you may have to make a sacrifice here, but any old patterns, habits that have been restricting you in the past, any role that you may have played in this past needs to go, okay? You need to be really honest with yourself here. Whatever's been restricting you, even if it's something that was not initiated by you, you need to acknowledge it. Okay, and then take a step back. The advice is to wait to see how things play out. So you're going to be in a limbo stage, I'd say starting probably about the second week of April, because you're waiting for some clarity here. And the only way you're going to do that, the advice is to hang back, step back. And I love the Hanged Man, because this usually does indicate a voluntary action on your own behalf to step out. You know, and be like, you know what? Okay, thank you for the offer. Let me think about it. Okay, be open to new perspectives, though. Okay, because any kind of delay could be in your own interest. Although I see that you are going to make a decision and move forward here. Okay, here's the new opportunity, the Page of Wands. This is your immediate future. And this is about that new journey moving forward, you know. So this is news. You're going to get this offer in April for a new beginning, a new job, a new journey, changes in your work, your career, your life purpose. Okay, embracing your own determination, your ambition, your primal energy to take back your power. Whatever this pain has been, feeling stabbed in the back, making sure you're staying on top of knowing that good things are coming because you're healing. And I feel like you're doing the work here, Gemini. You know what I'm saying? It's not like, you know, this is a very negative card here. This is so promising. You know, Archangel Michael can be playing a role here as well for you too, you know. I think the message is here to stay focused, stake your claim. When this offer comes in, I want you to step back. The advice is to consider all your options, to find the clarity that you need, because you could be feeling stuck. Or, you know, look, here's your obstacle, is the Ten of Cups. This is my happily ever after card, complete fulfillment, coming full circle in your life. Being so happy. And this is going to be your time to shine. This is going to be your time for that happily ever after. Or this could simply indicate that it's not exactly what you want, which I mentioned earlier. Like, in other words, you know you need X, say an income, to support your family, right? Or it's just, we're going to clarify this, okay? We're definitely going to clarify why the Ten of Cups is here as your obstacle, okay? Maybe this has something to do with, you know, some kind of deceit back here for a while, and you're stuck on what it was like, or you don't feel complete and you don't feel happy, okay? But this is a brand new beginning for you, Gemini, okay? So you're going to have to kind of pick yourself up by your bootstraps and, you know, pull these knives out of your back and decide that you're just going to move forward here, because you have to. You can't stay stuck here. And that's the tricky thing about these completion cards. The worst is over, but you know, if you lay there with the knives in your back, you're never going to be able to move forward. And even though I see you healing, there could be a part of you still that's having a tough time, you know, because you got the Ten of Cups too. You know, maybe you lost your family, that there's some kind of, interference here with your perception on your family, perception on your happiness, being stabbed in the back. How can you turn this around? How can I get over this pain? Maybe even losing your family. There's a couple of different scenarios coming through here, you know? But all, in the end, you got the Six of Pentacles. And this is tangible, real stuff, baby. This is financial security, feeling like you have enough. So I want you to go for it. I see you being able to make this decision and move forward in your life. And that is what's coming through the cards, to continue to move forward. This is beautiful opportunity. Increased support. Your positive focus and willingness to receive have opened the doorway to an abundance of help and opportunities. There you go. Here's your help. This is all about help coming in. And this is opportunity. So get yourself a little piece of, what do we got here? I don't even know how to say it. Oh, my Lord. I'm not even going to attempt. Okay, so screenshot that. Go get a little piece of this gem or crystal from Amazon, or you don't need a big piece, okay? You can leave this on you. It's going to help you heal and move through this process. It's really quite promising. Is that I just think the only thing here is that you're just going to have a little bit of a hard time making this sacrifice, creating the change that you want in your life, to move forward. There could be some extenuating circumstances with your family as well. Okay, maybe this like is a job in another state, and you're like, oh, but my family, I have to move my whole family, uproot my whole family. So you see where I'm going. For each one of you, it's going to be different. King of Wands, though, this is your influence, okay? So it's almost as if, you know, you're very impressed. You could go from this offer, this page, to this king, right? So the influence is here in the regard that you can manifest any goal that you want. Okay, and in simple terms, it's the offer. Okay, this is an offer being presented, and this is news about an offer being presented. So, wow. I mean, it's really, really great. I love this for you, Gemini. So let's see if we could dig in just a little deeper. What is this obstacle with the Ten of Cups? Give us a little bit more insight. Oh, victory. Victory. You're going to work out whatever this issue is. This is the Six of Wands. This is being victorious, reaching a major milestone in your life. You know, coming home after war, so to speak, with the laurel wreath. Having the support and the love. Oh, you got three cards coming through here. Whoa. You know, this is really amazing. You can celebrate with friends and family. Oh, boy. Hold on. Oh, my goodness. Sorry, guys. Oh, my God. Cards are flying all over the place here. Bear with me a minute. Death. Death and Scorpio. Okay. You're going to be victorious over these obstacles of having to deal with how this is going to work for your family or the pain that you've been suffering about a situation in your family that didn't work in your favor or having to move, okay? And you're going to be able to celebrate. You get the three of cups here, advancing, moving forward, and you're going to finally complete this cycle. Get the World card here. I mean, this... Honestly, Gemini, I mean, this is really amazing. Not only going to complete a cycle, but this is making room for another major arcana. You got one, now you got four, five, six major arcana. The universe has really got your back here. Now, the Death card, it's going to make it, I would say challenging, but if you keep in your heart and in your mind, you're making room for the new, as difficult as it might feel, or as you're going through it, know that it's all going to work out in the long run. Okay, does that make sense? So Scorpio is death and transformation, and this is moving into this new opportunity that is going to bring you joy and completion. Not only in what you want in your future and with money and opportunity, but being able to get rid of all that past stuff too, which I think is still lingering, you know, getting rid of this Ten of Swords energy. Okay, so Queen of Wands. Very, very interesting. Is that Sagittarius energy again that I'm feeling? I'm also getting like by October, your life is going to really be moving forward. I don't normally get timelines, but that just came through loud and clear as far as the trajectory of where you're going. I also feel this could be a family-based business you're getting involved with, or you could potentially be a partner here with somebody on a bigger level, bigger scale. Because the King and the Queen of Wands in one reading usually signifies partnership, couple, or something like that. I know you're an air sign, but there is some significance here that you may play just a larger role in this opportunity in the long run. Okay, this is manifesting what you want. You could also be dealing with a male and a female King and Queen of Wands. Okay, so page of cups at the bottom of the deck. Okay, another page, which is always, you know, quite promising as far as, you know, moving forward with your heart, getting the missing puzzle pieces, and embracing the opportunities for change and shifts in your life. Okay, there goes my dog. I'm sorry, he has a cough. This flew out as well, the Four of Pentacles. So, you know, I'd be really savvy. I wouldn't spend any unnecessary money at this time. You know, no big purchases in the month of April. But this does signify as well that you are building a new foundation for your future. So pretty incredible reading, Gemini. I'm loving this for you. What else is coming through? Get yourself some of this epilite. Okay. There's going to be more. And it's funny. I feel like through a shift in your own attitude or through this healing process, you're going to be granted this opportunity for positive change because you're going to manifest this, especially with the King and Queen of Wands here and the Page of Wands. This is something that you're going to be able to achieve. And if there's anybody that comes in to offer you help as well, I'm picking up that as well. Take advantage of it, okay? There is increased support for you overall in general for the month of April. So I'm going to leave it at that, Gemini. I hope you enjoyed the reading. If you want a private reading, my link is in the description box below. How you can contact me at theclaritycure.com. God bless you. Have a wonderful month, and we'll see you in the next one. All right, take care, Gemini. All right, bye-bye.